What is up, YouTube? That's Chris Bumstead intro. What's going on, YouTube? Hi, YouTube. I don't know. My brain is fried. It's Friday, and it's been a very, very long week. But anyway, guys, we're back. A little more consistent. It's been around 2 weeks since I last uploaded. Maybe 2.5. I don't know. I have a bad time frame. But we're here, Titan Home Gym. And we got some back going down today. But main reason why I'm making a video is because I wanted to address the fact, elephant in the room, I'm no longer bulking. It's been around 3 days since I haven't been bulking anymore, and I'm now maintaining. I didn't really want to hop right into a prep right after bulking for 9 months, 8.5, 9 months, but I just wanted to maintain. But we're gonna get into that a little later in the video, but just gonna hit you with this back workout really quick. Sipping on this pre, just finishing up. I think this is 4-peat by Raw Nutrition. I think we got a scoop and a half, and then we have Pump Squared, scoop and a half, also by Raw Nutrition. Catch you inside. Fortunately, I'm by myself today, so I got the tripod set up. It's not the best, but it'll do for now. Probably gonna start with some pull-ups. Probably do like 3 to 4 sets to failure. And I don't know, I'm gonna do something I haven't done in a while, whether it's a grip or exercise or even a movement, isolating something. Kinda wanna focus on the lats mainly today, because now that the bulk is over and now that I can get an idea of what my physique will look like, what I'll be basing my physique off, like when I start prep, I'm looking at my back. When I hit a double bicep or a lat spread, lats are there, but they could be a lot better. So definitely gonna be improving my lats over the next couple months, preparing to stage for the stage, but that's what we'll focus on and probably get right into it.
Gathered in their masses, just like witches at black masses. Evil minds that plot destruction, sorcerer of death's construction. In the fields of bodies burning, machine keeps turning. Death and hatred to mankind, poisoning their brainwashed minds. Oh, Lord, yeah.
Workout is over. It was approximately about 1:55. I don't know if you guys see that. Just wanted to do a quick physique update post bulk, because very first video, if you go back and rewatch that, you could see I was muscular, but I didn't have the size that I have now. You guys will see in a minute. But my peak weight this bulk was around 227 pounds. Last bulk, it was around 205 pounds. And it was also for a shorter time that I bulked. I bulked for only around, I think, 5.5, 6 months last year. This time was, I think, another week, it would have been 9 months. As you all know, originally, my goal was 230 pounds. And 230 pounds, obviously, did not happen. A couple reasons why it didn't happen. Number one, my weight wasn't fluctuating. I really don't know why. As much as I was trying to hit 230, I was at 227 one day. The next day I looked, I went down to 219. I don't know what it was, if it was water or not, but I told myself, you know what? Let me just cut it, you know? I gained almost around 40 pounds. I'm pretty sure it was like around 40 pounds. So that's enough pretty much muscle, because even if I did hit 230, it most likely wasn't gonna be quality muscle. It just would have been excess fat. So that's what happened with the bulk. It was a good 9 months, great 9 months. And after a while, the food made me start feeling sluggish. Like I was pushing food every 2 hours. It was a meal. It was come home, eat, gym. Come home from the gym, eat. 2 hours later, eat. 2 hours later, eat. 2 hours later, eat. I was pushing six, sometimes seven meals a day. And it was just really, really physically hard and mentally hard. More mental, because like I said, for the past like month, when I was pushing food like that, around 5,000 calories, it was really just mental. I was feeling really sluggish, and my sleep wasn't that good because I felt like I was just pushing all this food and I didn't get good digestion. Even though I was taking GI for your gut health, it'll aid digestion, but it still wasn't enough. And even the past couple days, ever since I started maintaining, I've been cutting those calories down and my sleep has become a whole lot better. Why? I don't know. But that's really it. We're gonna start maintaining. Well, we are maintaining. We're gonna be maintaining to around the end of July, which hopefully that's when my prep will start. Hopefully July 22nd, 23rd, sometime around there. It'll be a 16-week prep. And hopefully, fall goes according to the plan. Early November, I'll be competing. Definitely be keeping you guys updated with that. Right now, that's the plan. Still got a coach in the works. Nothing's 100% with a coach, but once that's 100%, I definitely will be letting you guys know. And let's just get this physique update rolling. Show you what I got in here. First up, we're gonna start with the base. I'll be using raw milk as my base instead of water or regular pasteurized milk or almond milk. Why raw milk? I'll get into that in another video. The whey we'll be using is peanut butter by Road Nutrition. As you can tell, I really like Road Nutrition. Got a scoop of our creatine in there. Also will be another video explaining why it's beneficial if you don't know already. Got the GI I was talking about from Revive. Got around 3 tablespoons of peanut butter in there. And around 2 tablespoons of honey in there for you. Like I said, all the macros will be up on the screen. And guess where I'm going, because we mentioned in the last video and it's definitely a coincidence, I'm getting a haircut in a few. So, gonna be hitting this, gonna go get a haircut. Once I come back, I'll be showing you guys my next meal. All right, we're here. Hair is cut. Forgot to show you guys the meal because I was hungry, but it's fine. But I did promise you guys a Q&A on Instagram. Just gonna pick randomly, pick 5 or 6 or so, just go along. First one, when was the moment you realized you wanted to pursue bodybuilding? So, when I first got on the fitness scene, before I started posting content and stuff, when I became knowledgeable about bodybuilding, it was actually around the 2009 Olympia, the famous quad stomp for Jay Cutler. If I can, I'll put it up on the screen. Hopefully I don't get copyrighted, but I don't think that's copyright. Anyway, that's when I became knowledgeable about it, and I really always thought it was cool. But, you know, I was always doing calisthenics. I was an athletic kid. I used to play basketball. Never really had time for the gym outside. I worked out here and there, but it wasn't anything crazy. my freshman year of high school when I started taking lifting seriously. That's when I started to do it, but I was only lifting because I was looking at, you know, the OG Gymshark crew and how they were lifting. And one person that actually influenced me was Anthony Mantello, because he was also really young at the time. I was only like 14, he was like 16, 17. But that's one person, but I didn't really know I wanted to bodybuild, you know. I was just lifting just to get bigger. And actually, up until around a year and a half ago, I didn't want to compete. I was all, competing's not for me. And then I was talked into it, decided I wanted to compete, and hopefully be competing this fall. Number two, we got best way to lose body fat, calorie deficit and cardio. I know people are going to tell you other things, how to lose this in 30 days, how to do that. There's no other way. There's no fast way. There's no shortcuts. Sure, there are alternatives, but the basis of how you're going to lose fat, you're going to have to go into a calorie deficit. So however your maintenance calories are, you're going to have to subtract that, and you're going to have to up your cardio. You know, you're going to have to increase cardio over time. Any more questions, hit my DM. Of course, I'm always going to be there. I'm always available for questions. I know it's early, but plans after your competition. So if all goes according to plan, doesn't have to be this show, but in the future, I am looking to go pro. I'm looking to get my IFBB pro card and become a professional bodybuilder. If all goes according to plan after this show, this competition, I'll be taking a pretty lengthy off season, around a year or so, and getting my health back up, getting my weight back up, because I'll be so depleted that I won't be that healthy. But I just want to rebound, get things going. Once I get my strength back, once I get a whole bunch of other things back, I'm just going to pretty much take a lengthy off season and then play it by ear from there. Where do you see yourself in 5 years when it comes to bodybuilding or just in general? Well, again, hopefully 5 years, be an IFBB pro, speak that into existence. In general, definitely like to have my business up and running, and I'd like to be relocated either in Texas or in Florida. It's a pretty good one. Bodybuilding versus powerlifting, personal thoughts and feelings and why you chose bodybuilding. Honestly, when I started lifting, I didn't know what powerlifting was. I had no idea what it was. I didn't know. It didn't make sense to me at all when I learned about it, but I didn't know what it was. So I guess I kind of had to go bodybuilding. But even if I knew what it was, quite honestly, just my opinion, I still think I would have chose bodybuilding. I think powerlifting is pretty cool. I just don't think it's for me, because I'm not that I'm focused on the physique, but you know, I find more satisfaction in chasing a physique and sculpting the perfect physique practically. A lot of people tell me, oh, you should try it. It's definitely not for me. I'll definitely watch it. I have a whole bunch of friends that do powerlift. Props to them. It looks hard. Looks cool too. You know, just picking up weight, putting it down. But it's not really my thing. Max deadlift. Ties with the powerlifting. I mean, I've deadlifted in the beginning when I first started training. But honestly, I don't really incorporate deadlifting into my split for back or legs or anything else. But when I did deadlift, last time I maxed out deadlift was well over 2.5, maybe 3 years ago. It was nothing, it was around 450, nothing crazy, 455. It was like 4 plates and a quarter. I'm gonna make this one my last one. What are your top 3 favorite supplements? And great content, bro, keep it up. First of all, thank you, bro, appreciate the love. In no specific order, I'm probably gonna go creatine. That's probably gonna be number one, even though I said no specific order. But I will be making a separate video informative video on creatine and different supplements. I will be going over my supplements and what I take on a daily. I'm gonna have to go creatine, pre-workout. It's another one. It's kind of basic, but I really enjoy pre-workout and it gives me that extra push. I don't really know. Whey? You know, I don't take too many supplements, you know? Like, I take my supplements, but I'm not that type of guy that's heavy on supplements, you know? I just, especially like when it comes to protein, yeah, I use whey, yeah, I'll put in a shake, whatever, like I did earlier. But I like my protein to come like from natural sources, so turkey, beef, chicken, stuff like that. And guys, that is it. That is gonna wrap it up for this video. All the socials are on the screen as usual. You guys already know the drill. Thank you. Like, comment, subscribe. Thank you guys for the continuous support. We're growing even more. And thank you for the support. I can't thank you guys enough. But that's gonna be it for this time. I'll see you guys next time.